And now, Predicaments, the VCR game. Hosted by the lovely Miss Joan Rivers. With Larry Anderson as Slate, Sharon Barr as Fetitia, Gordon Jump as George, Lou Leonard as Aggie, Kristi Somers as Cinnabar, and Arte Johnson as Alexander the Butler. Now, have fun.
Hi, I'm Don Johnson. Only kidding, only kidding. Before you start adjusting your television, I just wanted to see if you were paying attention, okay? Like the dress? You want to hear lucky? I found it on a chair right next to my husband's bed. And it came with its own hat and gloves and little garter belt. Isn't that lucky? Now, if you're like me, every time you play Predicaments, you want something to nibble on. And if you don't want to ruin that gorgeous manicure, I suggest something light, something nutritious, something elegant. Now, on to Predicaments. The reason I personally love Predicaments is because it's also a show that makes us a part of the scene. So when you give a line, deliver it with gusto. Just go Hollywood. Say it the way Sylvester Stallone would say it. Take off your shirt, even if you're a man. Now that you've got the acting technique under your belt, I would like to explain the game to you in three little words. Read the directions. You've read all the directions? Great. Now you should understand that Predicaments is unlike any other thing you've ever unwrapped before, including that little trampy stewardess Edgar's busy with in the kitchen. But I'd like to reinforce what you've just read. We have five actors and five favorite question categories. Who, what, where, when, and why. Why is my favorite? It's what Edgar's mother kept saying the first time she met me. Why, why, why? Now, you've got cards, you've got boards, we've got points, we've got wild cards, we've got winners, and we've got when. That's what Edgar says every time he reads my will. Now, when one of the characters asks a question in one of our five categories, one of you gets to respond with the appropriate answer. That's on the card from the category you're about to play. And you've got 12 chances to become the new Joan Collins or Larry Hagman in each scene. Now, when I say so, you press the pause button on your machine, okay? Now it's time to deal the 8 cards to each player and bid your hand. Then you start the machine up again. By the way, for the first round, it's been slowed down a little to let the novices practice. Now, good luck and no cheating. You hear that, Edgar? No cheating! No cheating in the game, and no cheating with that little trampy stewardess! I know what you're doing! I know what you're doing!
Ugh. I thought the last group that played this game was ugly. Well, here goes. This is Flat Mansion, also corporate headquarters of Flat Marbles. I am Alexander the Butler. Who are you? I could really care less, but they make me say that. I'm not sure Mr. Flat can see you right now. He's a very busy man, and personally, I wish you'd go away. But if you insist, let's look in.
Good morning, Father. How about hugs?
I told you, Slate, no hugs.
It's all part of being a butler, you know.
I did see something rather odd last night, Father.
That is no way to talk about your mother. Where's my marble?
Oh, where'd it go? Father, are we dumping marbles into the river?
Marble waste into the river? Since when?
Madam Rivers did say to deliver your answers with gusto. I thought they were abysmal. Pepto-abysmal.
I saw tiny little round things plunging into the wet place behind our home.
My home? Why are you telling me this?
Why are we dumping marbles?
Great answer. Did you study English as a second language?
And there's more, Dad.
What got me into this?
I deserve a better position. After all, I am a young urban professional.
A what?
Hasn't anyone heard of yuppies? Where have you been? Oh, nice comeback. Who gave you that one? I've noticed, sir, you are slowing down.
So dear old Dad should just turn all of the marbles over to you, huh? Who do you think you are?
A man for the job, sir.
Out!
The big job.
Out!
Your job, sir.
Out!
When do I start?
Out!
Okay, who's winning? Well, congratulations! And they all said you were an idiot when you were out of the room. But the joke's on you. That was just a practice round. By now, I think all you've sort of got the hang of the game, okay? But I just wish somebody would explain Slate. I mean, is that Rambo with a resume? I mean, what is his excuse to dress like that? The man is not going to go in the subway or anything. And the father. How can a man run a marble empire when he's lost all of his? Edgar! Why is she putting a mattress on my kitchen table? Hello.
Hello?
Hello, darling.
Patricia, how was your flight? When did you get here?
I can't believe you found the original will.
What did he leave me? Terrific. With that, I could afford to put a down payment on a bus token.
I think the real dirt is somewhere in his filing cabinet.
Why can't you get at it?
Besides, he keeps it locked. Where are you staying? All these years now, and finally, the big moment is about to arrive.
By the way, what type of hors d'oeuvres is your host serving?
I'd send out if I were you.
Who says our little plan won't work?
What can stop us now?
I think those hors d'oeuvres are affecting you.
George is still married to his business, and yet he's still so sexy. When will my marriage be normal and happy?
Why worry about that? If your plan works, we'll both get everything and very soon. Okay? Where is he?
Fetitia, there's only one question left in my life. What do I want?
You'll get it. See you in an hour, darling.
Bye. Mirror, mirror in my hand. Who's the foxiest in the land?
Guess who's in here? They wouldn't be caught dead here, unlike you. Woo.
Good morning, Mr. Flatt.
My, the river looks so beautiful today, doesn't it?
Who could possibly think otherwise?
So, how is everything?
Oh, I'm sorry, that was a bit vague.
Her mind is a bit vague, but let's face it, she wasn't hired for that.
Now, what would you like? Oh, my golly gosh, I should know your needs. Where is my head? Life is learning, all right, but sometimes acquiring knowledge can be so difficult. Why is that, Mr. Flat?
Turn down the volume, imbecile!
Dreadfully sorry. Mr. Imbecile.
When is my first appointment?
You must be busy. What are you working on?
Nosy, isn't she? Speaking of noses, where did you get yours? I'd ask for my money back if I was you.
Darn me! Why can't I do things right?
Hello, I'm...
Fetitia Mann of Marvel's Monthly Magazine, here to interview George Flatt, Marvel's legend extraordinaire.
The mystery woman. What does she want? You are sick.
Who's out there?
The more appropriate question is, what was out there? Regular comedian, aren't you?
So, darling, that was your favorite tournament. Can you tell me why?
I like to call it domestic surveillance.
Where did you get your famous nickname?
Tomahawk thumb. Ooh, I'd almost forgotten about that. You know when I got that title?
And now the plot thickens. Guess who's coming to visit George?
And when did you take over?
My father, Alan Flatt, went to that big marble ring in the sky.
Didn't he have another son? I heard he disappeared. Who was he?
Yes, it was my brother Fred. How about if I show you my thumb? You know, I can place a marble any place you wish. Where would you like it?
Kinky. Who taught him all this stuff? It's nice to have role models.
Place the shooter right in here, like this.
Why does that grip look so familiar?
Why there? I heard some players name their favorite marbles. Do you?
Meet Bubba.
Why does he always have to talk about Bubba?
Do you know who inspired that name?
Buttocks.
Let me guess. George's new secretary.
And you must be the little woman. Who else could she be? My name is Cinnabar. Now, what would you like, Aggie?
Could we perhaps get the writers in here? We need better answers for this game. Dreadful boo.
Aggie, do you see any reason why we can't get along?
We'll get along just as long as you don't get along too well with George.
Oh, we'll get along as long as you don't get along too well with George.
Who cares?
Where did you two meet?
I try to spend every waking moment with George. Guess when we were last apart.
Gosh, it must be great to have that kind of relationship.
Relationship? When did that Bimbette learn such big words?
And we've kept our marriage fresh by making one small addition to our private life.
And what was that?
And do you know who it once belonged to? Wow! When did you get it?
Oh, he's in there with somebody.
Who? I'm going in there. Why shouldn't I?
That's an excellent grip. I feel you've really got the hang of it there.
Who is your friend, George?
Aggie. I'd like for you to meet Fetitia Marble of Man's Monthly. Aggie, what can I get for you? Oh, well, I'm afraid we're fresh out of that. Now, where were you, honey?
I may have missed the game, but I still know the score. Let me play. Pick them up, George. You're losing your marbles. Oh, why do you play such a stupid game anyway?
This is enough.
When are you ever going to learn to call before you come visit?
Heads up, George! Oh, who could resist such a foxy face?
Oh, Mr. Flat, darling, you're so lucky to have a wife who shares your interests, your passions, your marbles.
Why aren't you laughing? Really?
Where's that other marble?
You're such a cute crawler, George. Why don't you do it more often?
I think I should be going.
Speaking of going, when are you leaving? You can't take a hint, can you?
Aggie, what's really on your mind?
Come on, George. I'll show you.
I wonder where they're going. Flunked sex education, did you? Where did they go?
You know, I'm supposed to meet Slate here. I wonder where he is.
You need a lunch break.
Lunch for George? Warm up the forklift.
Oh, doggone it. I've got some contracts to review.
George, when are we going to have some time to ourselves?
Aggie, sit down. Why did I say that?
Just relax and I'll turn you on.
Aggie, I've got a business to run.
Where do I fit in?
Why can't you understand about my work?
What's that? Wrong. George, when are you going to grow up?
Where is your sense of humor? Okay, can't argue that.
Okay, let's share a kiss and then you can go back.
But.
Oh, now that was a kiss.
Boy, it sure rattled my marbles.
Oh, darling, what could be better?
I've got a lot of unfinished office work I need to take care of. I'll see you at dinner.
George, I'm bored. Where should I go? Why is he so irresistible to me?
It all begins to make sense, yes. Yes, yes.
Like it? It's Liberace's old jammies. Anyhow, here's to us. Beer, life isn't easy. The last time a man said to me, "This bud's for you," he was aiming the bottle at my head. But don't you just love these people? I mean, their lives make mine seem wonderful. That's why I love playing predicaments. I just invited all my friends over to play. I still have 3 chairs left over. Anyhow, how's your game going? Any more schnitzels? And what's going on with George and Aggie? I guess it's the story of most marriages. She's slaving over a hot stove and he's doing the same over a hot date. And that Cinnabar, good body, but hey, no brains. You want to get her crazy? Say to her, "Cinnabar, spell mom backward." I mean, the woman is a tramp. This is Typhoid Mary in a sundress. Anyhow, it's time to move on, and good luck to whoever isn't winning. With this body, I always identify with losers. Good year.
Gosh, working for a magazine. Where was your last interview?
Could you deliver the answers with more enthusiasm, please?
Who did you interview?
Scintillating. And who would want to read that drivel? Why can't you people give semi-intelligent answers? I thought as much.
And who might you be?
She's doing an article for Marvel's Monthly.
Slate's my name. Security's my game. Where have I seen you before?
What is that?
Simply a symbol of my virile manhood.
You don't need symbols, Slate.
Incidentally, who decorated that abode you're in? It looks it.
Why are you so interested in my body, odd lady?
Who could resist a man like him?
Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Why do you want to interview me? Tell me! What is it that you're really after?
Sometimes a cigar is just a cigar.
She's right, you know. She's right.
Oh, that's it. Time to hang up the thumb.
Where would he hang it? Odd place for a thumb.
Where is Cinnabar when you need her? Ooh.
My job is to help you. Guess who's here to cheer you up? Why is he so glum?
My whole life is going right down the tube.
Why doesn't he leave so she could cheer me up?
I've got a son who's a vulture for my chair, a wife who loves me to exhaustion. Worst of all.
Heaven forfend, not the family fortune.
I've lost my touch with marbles.
Thank God, my position is safe.
Well, you look super. Who says you're over the hill?
Besides, this is gone.
What is gone? Could be worse.
Then why doesn't he have it treated?
You know, I remember winning my first tournament.
That must have been a real high. Where was it held?
They don't hold marble tournaments in Dodger Stadium, you know.
But what did you get for winning?
Yeah. That's all in the past. I'm all washed up.
Let me relax you, Mr. Flat.
What'd you have in mind?
Actually, I've got a better idea.
Where could we go?
Or we could do it right here.
Some things call for privacy, but not this.
I already asked your father to show me your pretty gardens.
But who would you prefer to go with? Yo, can it?
People should speak their minds freely.
Only if you have them.
Either she's a bundle or I'm Ella Fitzgerald. Where would you get such a package? Come on, Cinnabar. Let's get out of here.
Now. Who is first?
Stop talking about my father like that. What do you think you are, anyway?
Son? Who are you talking to? Would you like to see the garden?
She's coming with me, Father.
Why? Can't you ruin her life later?
That's no reason. Ruin her life, Slate. Ruin it!
The individuals in this family can be so cruel to each other. When will it cease? Slate, why do you put me in this position?
When are you going to bring her back?
Well, I'm ready for a man in the garden. Who's first?
Coming, Snookums.
With Cinnabar gone, what will the master use for a plaything? You are crying for help.
Well, I see you enjoyed the garden.
Now it's your turn, Mr. Flat.
When will this thumb stop hurting?
After that massage, I can't understand why it still hurts.
My, aren't we naive?
Maybe you could rub it for a second or two more.
Kinky.
Where did you learn how to do this, Cinnabar? I must be nuts to let you touch my body.
The old my thumb needs a rub trick, huh? Pretty sad, Dad. When are you going to get some new material?
Listen, boy. You're on guard duty tonight. Where are you going now?
I could believe that.
Actually, Dads, Cinnabar and I are headed for the gym. Golly, Dads, is there no one in the world who can please you? Oh, lighten up, Father. What do you need from me?
Oh, Mr. Flat, don't forget you have to meet your wife at 6 o'clock.
Would you mind telling me where?
Did she say the grocery store?
She has the car. Why do I drive there?
Relax it, Dad. Why so intense?
Maybe I should stay and finish rubbing his digit.
But you promised we'd work out together. Who will I exercise with? Cinnabar, with the hours we both put in, when do we have time to enjoy ourselves?
Okay, Slate. You're right. Let's go.
Goodbye, Dad.
Hurry with the marble cake, George.
Oh. Why are you always in such a rush, Aggie?
Actually, George, I've got a little surprise planned for us. That's the reason I gave the butler the night off.
Night off, my...
And when, may I ask, are you going on guard duty, Mr. Head of Security?
1,100 hours, Dads. Everything's under control. What are you so worried about?
Right. I know what situation you'd like to get your hands on.
My baby has a new love interest. Who is she?
Her name is Cinnabar, Mums, but I don't believe you've met.
That cake looks marvelous, George. Who baked it? I believe I'll just pass on the cake.
Good.
Well, Slate, I must say I do approve. I met Cinnabar this morning.
You like Cinnabar? Why?
That's the reason I like her, too.
If Cinnabar's interested in Slate, then it's less likely that you'll, quit her job.
I don't agree that Slate's advances are going to help her cause any. Leave her alone.
But, Dad, with the hours you've got me working, where am I supposed to go meet women?
Your regular spot, I presume.
And when were you there, George?
On business.
Sure, George. Now, who believes that? And you won World War II?
Very cute, George. Very cute.
Say, Dad, I've got something I want to show you. It's right here.
And what is that supposed to be?
Well, it's a camouflage marble. You see, the frontline troops will be safe from sun-like sparkles reflecting off and getting in the eyes, giving away our position.
Oh. Will you tell me where we're fighting a war?
Oh, well, time for me to move out. See you.
Sometimes I worry about that boy. Who does he get those crazy ideas from?
Look, one hand.
Look, no hands. Oh, I love these family evenings when Melissa, Edgar, and I gather around this piano trying to figure out how we're going to pay for it. But back to the game. These people are crazed. George brags that when he was in school, his hairline was voted most likely to recede. And Aggie? I mean, you have to feel sorry for a woman whose charm school correspondence course was obviously lost in the mail. And for Tisha, is that a voice that could break a lease? Excuse me. No, he's in the kitchen. We can talk. Your place and mine. Mine? Even better. My exterminator. This thing's filled with bugs. Anyhow, I can't wait to see what happens to George and the gang, but I'm famished. So while Aggie wigs out, I'm gonna pig out. I love to eat. We got married. Edgar and I exchanged onion rings. Edgar, leave the stewardess alone! The whipped cream's my pumpkin pie! Lifestyles of the rich and famous.
My only vice, a cup of hot chocolate to soothe the savage beast.
Where would he conceal incriminating evidence? Anything's possible. I wonder when Rambo swings by on guard duty. Aggie mentioned something about something. What was it? No, it was the file cabinet. Where is it?
What was that? Rather noisy for that, don't you think?
Evening, ma'am. What can I get for you?
And the proof about your father's marbles dumping. Don't just stand there. Start scooping.
I don't do floor work. Why should I? I wasn't talking to you.
Look, I'm not buying this reporter garbage. Just exactly who are you?
Someone wants to know when you're going to take your rightful place in the company.
What's in it for me?
Plus the satisfaction of...
Save it for Tisha. I'm not buying. Where does she think I come from? Look, marbles dumping alone isn't enough to get you into the executive suite. Just exactly what else do you have on us?
I'm planning a corporate takeover of Flats Marbles. We'll need the fresh blood of a young buck.
The blood of a young buck? Ugh. I don't think I care for any more hot chocolate.
Where is my black teddy?
I don't like black.
Why not?
Pink is nice, though.
And just who have you seen in a pink negligee? Remember the night I wore a pink negligee? Oh.
I sure do. When was that?
Pale blue. Blue is nice.
What can you wear with it?
All right, George, I give up. What would turn you on? You're naughty. I don't remember this nightgown. Where did it come from? George, who does this nightgown belong to?
You wound me, sweets. I gave you that on our fifth wedding anniversary. Why do you keep interrogating me like this?
Close your eyes!
When do I get to open them?
Hello, face cakes. Guess who's back in town? Guess who's in big, big trouble?
Let him have his fun. Why make a fuss over silly little party hats?
Dr. Truth. Who else helps people this much?
Hello, Madam F. What's on your mind? My husband George is the biggest marble manufacturer in town, but he's married to his business.
I do believe it's Mrs. Flatt about to go public with her dirty linen.
Yes, well, what do you want out of your marriage?
Where have I heard that voice before?
Where do you want your marriage to go, my dear?
Oh, how idyllic.
It's Aggie.
Give your husband an ultimatum. When was the last time you made love?
Gosh.
Tell him you want respect and attention. That you want the fulfilling life.
I have. And you know who he says I remind him of?
And you remind me of Trigger.
You may have more problems than even Dr. Truth can help you with.
Gosh, who do you turn to if Dr. Truth can't help you?
My suggestion is set time limit. If nothing happens, file for divorce. Half of anything is better than all of nothing.
Oh, Dr. Truth, why are men men?
There's only one question that has any relevance. Who are you?
A woman determined to win her husband back. But just in case, do you know where I can find a good lawyer?
Please call again, Madam F. Good night.
Great. Where can I go and hide? Cinnabar, why are you a...
I'm always hungry after exercise.
Where did you get a body like that?
How does one get there?
You could have this body, Mr. Flatt.
He should be so lucky.
Good. Do you know what comes next? Mr. Flatt, is there something wrong between you and Mrs. Flatt?
Oh, who didn't hear my wife on Voice of America?
Maybe you should take a vacation.
Where should I go?
That's my personal favorite. I meant Aggie, too.
Ooh. Play that part again. I like watching it. Hot.
It's not easy running a company. Do you know when I had the last day off?
But Slate can take over while you get away.
Slate? Do you know what that boy wants?
He wants to take over the company.
I wonder who Master Slate would appoint as vice president. Remind me to sell my stock in flat marbles.
Why do you think I refuse to give him any control?
Where do you see him fitting in?
It's been a long day, Cinnabar. Why don't we go to bed?
Okay.
Ooh, Cinnabar, my little dove of love. Ooh.
Just love this outfit. By the way, it's not Liberace's jammies. But when it comes to clothes, my motto is beg, borrow, or steal. So I'd like to thank my friend Maxine for the dress, Visa for the boa, and Murray for the pumps. Now, what are you doing with this game? And what is Patricia's story? I don't want to say the woman's voice is low, but I think she has one of the Oak Ridge boys under her dress. And that mercenary guy, I think they named him Slate because his was empty. My theory is he was involved in a brain transplant and he was the donor. And what are you doing with your lines? I'm having a little difficulty with Cinnabar. I mean, that is a body on the woman. She could ring a doorbell with her arms filled with groceries. Now, you just go ahead and keep playing and I'll stand here and do my exercises.
And now the plot thickens. Guess who's coming to visit George? No, lame brain. The mystery woman.
Why don't you tell me how you really got your company? I heard you cheated your younger brother out of it.
Where did you hear that?
And from your wife. She sent me a copy of the will. All she wants is togetherness for her family.
You're not from Marbles Monthly. Who are you?
There is a resemblance, isn't there?
I've had it with you. I'm gonna call the police.
Go ahead, darling. I'm sure they'll be interested to learn how you destroyed the original will, stating that a marbles match was to be played between you and your brother to determine who got the company.
Big deal. Why is that important now?
Because I'm your brother, Fred.
I wonder if she'll need a butler.
Look at you.
Volvos aren't the only things made in Sweden, darling.
My golly, Fred, why did you do it?
A man's gotta be what a man's gotta be.
All right. Fred, what do you want?
My rightful place in the company.
I built this company. Who needs you?
The will states you have to play me for all the marbles. And I have a copy to prove it.
Where is this supposed copy of the will? I believe you all right, Hotshot. Look, I could beat you when you were a boy. I can certainly beat you now that you're a girl. When do you want to play?
Make it high noon.
You got it. Where? No. You choose the time, I choose the place. Right here.
A fitting place for your final defeat.
Do you know who you're playing? All right, mouth athlete. We'll see if you're made of something other than silicone, spandex, and super glue.
Notify your lips to receive.
Receive what?
I've got the best treat since tofu tacos.
Son, you are sick. When are you two gonna concentrate on work?
Dads! What can we get him?
I'm fine. Why did I come in here? I recall. Slate, do you know who you let in my office?
Dad's no. When?
Mr. Flat, why are you so upset?
Wouldn't you be upset if your long-lost brother returned as your sexy, as your sister?
I guess so.
Probably.
That Fetitia woman was once my brother Fred. Who could believe such a thing?
Where is Fetitia now?
We're going to play a game of marbles, and the winner gets everything I have. Including you. Why does everything happen to me?
Where does this duo dance?
Listen, Lockjaw. I paid for your brain. When are you going to start to use that thing?
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please.
Son, we are the only people in this room. Who are you yelling at?
All right now, folks, settle down. The game's about to start. Rah! Mr. Flat loves to cheat.
In this corner, George Flat, the cheat. Honor champion and alleged ne'er-do-well, and, what else? And in this corner, what do we call you?
Uncle still works for me, darling.
Uncle Fetitia, Master Flat, who should I cheer for? Wrong. The winner.
All the way from... where are you from? Or at least a nearby zip code, my uncle, the aunt.
When do we start?
Never, if you don't stop giving the referee guff. Then who will you turn to?
I have a bribe offer here. Who do I make it to? I would prefer someone with authority.
Since I'm in charge of the score, I'd be the logical choice.
Right, Mom.
Slade, darling, where do you want your Uncle Fetitia to stand?
First, you must lag.
Nervous?
Why should I be worried about losing to you?
What makes you think you have even a chance?
Why is Mr. Flat so confident? Oh, there's a confidence builder.
George is on the brink of disaster. When have you seen such a contest? Ooh. George knuckles down. Where could you find better technique?
Well known as the marbles capital of the world, eh?
Get out of here. Who cares anyway?
Why are you so blind, George?
I have absolutely no respect for you.
Look around, George. What do you see?
What are you waiting for?
Will all of you get off my back?
If you don't shoot now, you'll lose your turn. Where would you hide your shame then, George? Well, this will be the game's final shot. If Atisha can tie it up, we'll play another game. Otherwise...
I have to leave. When will this next game be?
I shall make that my day off.
I win, I win, I win! Hey, who wants to party?
Sorry, Dadams, you know the rules. Liners count if most of the marble is out.
It's a tie! A tie! Well, I play another.
Who would have thought that it would come to this? I'm sick of your smart answers.
The fact that you tied is symbolic. Who doesn't see that?
Of course they don't see it. They're not here. When will you learn how to play this game? You need training wheels for your brains.
I'm not going to keep score anymore.
Where are you going to go?
Dad, you've got to look at the big picture. Why don't you just admit that they're right?
George, do you know what I really want?
That is, if Aggie's lawyer doesn't take that too.
Mr. Flatt, why don't you let her explain?
You are far too kind. This woman is the reincarnation of a donut.
All I wanted was for us to be brothers, together. Why can't we be that?
Who's recording this for posterity?
Always one step ahead of the masses. Work, work, work.
George, please, leave it a tie and let her be your brother. When will you come to your senses?
Say I let you in the company. Where would you fit in? I didn't know we had a plant there.
Actually, that's the place I selected to properly dispose of our marbles waste. Oh.
Okay, I'll do it. Welcome to Flat Marble.
Yeah. Oh, bravo!
What have we become?
No. A family!
Oh. Oh. Wait a minute. Another family member, another room to clean, another plate at dinner. Why am I cheering? Actually, I'm cheering because I won't have to deal with you nits anymore.
Okay, I want to compliment all of you on your acting abilities. Who knows? Some glossies, an agent, a little sleeping around, and you could become a sex symbol like me. Oh, stop crying. We had a good time. Anyhow, here's to Cinnabar and Patricia / Fred and all the rest of my favorite people. But most of all, here's to you. You played a very good game.